The real estate market in Brighton is really a good news, bad news story. The good news, new projects adding inventory to the market.
The bad news, like every other Boston neighborhood, prices continue to rise. Erica Tarantelle shares details from her house hunting tour.
One of the things that's really kind of emerging as a movement in Brighton is a concern for more home ownership. Home ownership has dropped down a bit over the past few years.
State Senator Will Brownsberger says the drop is due in part to the lucrative market in student rentals.
It's real easy for four kids who are getting supported by their parents at Harvard or Boston College to support $4,000 a month in rent. The incentives for landlords to accommodate students instead of a working family is huge.
Now new development is popping up in Brighton, but what does it cost to live here? In popular Oak Square, a brand new condo complex, 99 Tremont Street, with 62 new units.
Lots of the buyers are owner-occupants, and they're young professionals.
Diane Kelleher is president of Kelleher Real Estate.
The studios start at $499. The one bedroom start in the mid fives. The two bedroom start in the mid sevens. The demand for housing is so strong in Boston. The lack of inventory has been going on for years, which has really driven the prices up.
No question, 99 Tremont is fancy. In addition to the sleek styling, there's a lounge and media room with catering kitchen, a garden with grills, and a fitness center. Plus, there's the ultimate city dweller's prize.
Every unit comes with a parking space, which is really unusual to get a studio with parking or a one bedroom with parking.
Kelleher says this is just the beginning for Brighton.
It's booming and it's about to boom even further.
If all goes as planned, this shuttered 12-acre site near St. Elizabeth's Hospital in Brighton Center could eventually look like this. What used to be here? St. Gabriel's Monastery.
St. Gabriel's has a number of existing buildings on the site. One is the St. Gabriel's Monastery that was built in 1909. St. Gabriel's Church was built in 1929. About 10 or 15 years ago, the property was abandoned and has been used primarily as a parking lot.
John Sullivan is vice president of the real estate firm Cabot, Cabot and Forbes. He says his firm will build a 650-unit complex of condos and rentals, catering to graduate students, young professionals, and families.
Other than the historic preservation, there's 3 acres of open space at the front door to the site that we plan to rehabilitate and incorporate into the overall plan. We're excited to be part of Brighton and Alston as it changes, and doing it in a way that kind of respects things that have been here for a while.
But available single-family houses are rare. A broker with Prime Realty Group, Norman O'Grady, has been working in the Alston-Brighton market for 25 years.
Maybe even about 10 years ago, you could get a single family for approximately $420,000, even $375,000, depending on the type of home you're getting. In today's market, the average price range for a single family home is $750,000.
And no surprise, houses often sell fast and over asking. This 1,900 square foot, 9-room, 4-bedroom colonial near Brighton Center was recently on the market for $775,000. It sold for over asking to Kirsten Henry and her family.
This home here is just off Commonwealth Ave, believe it or not. It gets a lot of sunlight, they have a beautiful extension, lots of windows all around.
Henry moved back to her hometown after living in California.
I feel like Brighton has always been a gem. I think that maybe as more people come to realize and value their time and the desire to have more things to do close by, they're realizing that Brighton is a community that absolutely offers that, and it has something for everybody.
And back to the St. Gabriel's project. If all goes as planned, they will break ground in the spring, assuming the ground isn't still frozen at that point. And it'll take about 2 to 3 years to complete that.
That's great. And those 62 condos at 99 Tremont, well, 29 of them have been sold and are under agreement. The building has a lot of amenities. It's just a great addition to the neighborhood.
Up next, exercising the mind and body.
Observe this display of body and mind control.